passenger.
No, I'll just do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thems and theys, all the people that we love, you have 15 minutes until the show starts. Go get your last drink. Go have your last hello, because in 15 minutes, we are gonna get loaded!
Look at all these bright eyes! Look at all these hearts ready to be filled! You know, it's funny, I see a few of you looking to your left, wondering if that person knows what the hell is going on. I see some of you looking to your right, wondering if you know who the heck this handsome devil with the flash goggles and the projecting voice sending joy to the universe is. Some of you know, as I hear. For those of you that don't, allow me to introduce myself. I am the mystifying, mesmerizing, satisfying king of the night. I am the Rain City Ranter, the best in the Northwest, the mouth that goes south. Mr. Clean, clean, clean for all your late night needs. And let me just let you know, my nails are trim. She knows what I mean. Jackson Lowe, acknowledge me. And how good it feels to be back in the city of hustle, the city on wheels, the city of music, the city of life and rock and roll, the city where the Iroquois, Potawatomi, the Ottawa, the Huron once roamed the land where the water curves round. I'm talking about the city so nice they named it thrice. Détroit, Détroit, Détroit! Not gonna lie, for a minute, it was a hard decision for Jackson Lowe to come back. Once upon a time, there were hard times for Jackson Lowe just down the street in the Cass Corridor where Jackson Lowe lived in a shitbox basement apartment. How do I know it was a shitbox? Because it was lettered instead of numbered. And I had dreams. I had dreams of rising up from the letters to the names. I had dreams and goals of going out and making something of myself.
Jackson Lowe, I want to help your baby.
Too late, snip, snip. It's everyone's responsibility. I just want to make sure that's clear. I had dreams of making something of myself across time and space, of getting out, being more, finding myself in a situation where I wouldn't crawl back, I would fly back first class and hit that tarmac. And I did. I ran and I jumped. I ran and I jumped that train. I ran, I jumped that train, and I headed out west to the city of rain. a city of emeralds where anything can happen. It was there where Jackson Lowe became a four-time World Wrestling Federation champion. Not the WWF that you think, but a very different one. It was there where I gained a golden mic in Seattle, semi-pro wrestling. And it was there that Jackson Lowe made some friends. And these friends and Jackson taught the world to get loaded. We taught the world from Seattle to Portland, from Portland, Oregon to Portland, Maine, from Paris, Texas to Paris, France. We went all over the world and we learned it all. And ladies and gentlemen, tonight we are back here in Detroit, Michigan. Now let me tell you a bit about what we learned. We learned it's not the size of the beer can pyramid that matters. It's who helps you build it up to such great heights. It's not the length with which your wizard staff is drunk. It is with whom you're jousting. It's not the darkest seat in the darkest corner of the darkest bar where you sit alone and you drink the drink with the stupidest name. I would probably also drink that drink, but it's that empty seat at the bar next to the stranger where a connection is made, where you make a new friend, where we find out through time and space. It's about coming together. It's about knowing each other. It's about finding out that we have so much in common, that we're in this together, that we're doing it all together. Time, space, gravity, it's ours. It's ours to share, it's ours to know, it's ours to live, it's ours to love, it's ours to embrace and especially share. And it's not hard. It's not hard. We just gotta open our mouths and learn something about each other and find out what we have in common. And you know what? I believe that we have at least two people in common. And we'll get to that later, I promise. But it's about doing all of this together. It's about growing. And like, do you think back in 1902, when 67,292,504 tons of shipping commerce went through the Detroit River, do you think that was one person loading that ship up, sending that ship on down the line,
no.
Going and drinking alone at the bar that night? I need to hear it louder. Do you think that's the case? They were doing it together, sending these needs, sending the life from here to there and beyond. Just like we are here right now to share this moment. And we have this moment in common, and we always will. But I bet we have more in common than just this. I'll bet we can find... Do you like spaghetti?
I love spaghetti.
He loves spaghetti! I love spaghetti! My friend, Let's be friends. How do you feel about rock and roll?
I love it.
Goddamn right you love rock and roll! Woo! Because you know what Jackson Lowe also loves? Rock and roll! Now, you don't gotta wait for me to be doing this. I want you all to look at someone next to you. Just ask them something that you think they might have in common with you. You got 10 seconds. Go. Now make sure to give them a wristband. Make sure to give them a friendship bracelet. We're finding out that we have a lot in common. Am I right? But I feel like we can see this in action more. Is there anyone here that came to this event without a date? Come on, come on up. Come on up. Look at you! Oh, you are gonna have a great night, I promise you. Friend, what is your name?
Star.
Star! Where are you from, Star?
I guess Warren, Rhode Island.
Warren, Rhode Island! I have nothing to say about Rhode Island except lobster rolls.
Most people don't have a lot to say.
That's fine.
Wait, one thing. Nobody in Detroit knows Rhode Island exists. They're like, is that in Massachusetts? 3 times.
Close. But we also know it's not in the UP, and that's fine. So look, Star, do you have a preference towards boys, girls, or does it matter?
It doesn't matter!
All right. Star, I want you to come along with me. Let's go over here. We're going over here. Oh, this doesn't suck. This is going to be great. Because I'll tell you exactly why. In this beautiful, romantic space, drinks will be provided for you. Comfort will be brought to you. And this romantic music will be played for you. Now, I need 3 more people who are here without a date. 3 more people. One here, come on. Come on up. That's one. Yeah, come on, just come on. All right. Stand here. 2 more people without a date. Come on, I know there's more people than this here. I asked, it was like, please tell me not everyone brought a ham sandwich to the buffet. We got two. Can I get a third? I got pointing right here at this person. Come on up. All right. You stand here. All right. Let's start with number one here. Whoa, those shoes. Those shoes. Well done, friend. What is your name?
Menasha.
Menasha, where are you from?
L.A. County.
L.A. County. Menasha from L.A. County. City of Angels. All right. Menasha, what are you drinking?
Water.
Water. Drinking water. And that's good. That's good. You got to stay hydrated. I want to make sure it's clear. While we're getting loaded doesn't necessarily just mean alcohol. Loaded also means getting loaded on love. All right. Menasha. From L.A., drinking water. Friend, what's your name?
Molly.
Hey, Molly, where are you from?
Seattle.
Molly from Seattle. Emerald City. Molly, what are you drinking?
Vodka.
All right. Ooh, just vodka, no mixer, straight in the mixer. All right. Okay. Menasha from L.A. County. Molly from Seattle. Friend, what is your name?
Jake Bratrude!
Ooh, wait a minute. You don't mean Jake Bratrude of the Wenatchee Bratrudes, do you?
I do certainly mean that.
Ooh! Jake Bratrude of the Wenatchee Bratrudes, what are you drinking?
Beer.
Drinking beer! A hearty choice. All right, ladies and gentlemen, what we're going to do now is you are going to vote on who gets to spend the evening hanging out with Star, getting to know each other, finding a connection, seeing if a connection grows to more. Do you vote for Menasha from LA County? It's okay. Do you vote for Molly from Seattle? Or do you vote for Jake Bratrude? Have a seat. Have a seat, please. Molly, have a seat right here. They sparkle, they shine. I love this. So friends, I want you to hang out, relax, enjoy yourself. Now, great, well, you know what? You might eventually drink some vodka, but first, let's talk about that social lubricant that is sometimes necessary. Again, not always, but sometimes. And let's go up on stage here and let's meet our bartender who came all the way from Mexico City. Ladies and gentlemen, from the American Legion and Rebar and beyond, I give you Grant! Motherfucking Badger! Grant Badger, how the hell are you? It's been for so long.
I love seeing you again, Jackson Lowe. I've missed you. I've missed you so much.
Jackson Lowe loves to be seen and loves to be missed. So Grant, I hear you dug deep in the memory, you dug deep in the heart spot, and you thought of something that you felt appropriate for the night. Can you tell us about it?
I can. Oh, okay. Look, no hands. So we got a little drink whipped up, and it comes from an origin, from a nickname that I gave to the lovely prize girl, Brandi, who I met. And when I met her with that name, I thought, that's a good name, but I'm going to give you another nickname. Brandi, Branding Iron Bratrude. So this drink, in honor of her, is the Branding Iron. And we got a little mezcal. We have some hibiscus tea. In Mexico, we'll call that agua de Jamaica. It's mixed here with a little simple syrup, equal parts. And we're going to add a little soda water to it, shake it up. And it's going to be delicious. Everyone can enjoy this drink at some point in their lives.
Well, let's see what happens when you put it all together and you shake it up. All right, so it's got the ice. The ice is going in the mixing glass. You're taking the mezcal. Let's see how much mezcal he puts in. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. So the first time Jackson Lowe ever learned how to pour a drink, he learned one count is like a quarter ounce. So you go uno, dos, tres, cuatro, and you just poured an ounce. I learned that I had to count it in Spanish. Otherwise, it was a heavy-ass hand.
I will say, rebar bartenders, like Kirsten, who's here in the audience as well, we learned our count from the original owner of rebar. His name, Stephen Allen Wells. If you say it slow, you get a real good drink.
Euro style. All right, and in comes the hibiscus and simple mixture.
I'm gonna air, ¿quieres en español? Agua de Jamaica con jarabe sencillo. I'm gonna err on the side of light, not strong for that. I think alcohol is a sugar. You don't need to add that much sugar. That's my personal preference. Talk to your bartender about it. Make a friend.
Connections. All right, so we got that. We got the mezcal. We got the soda.
Tiny bit of soda water. Never hurts anything.
Never hurts anything. All right, it's going in. I'm gonna add the shaker. Let's see him shake. Look at him shaking it, shaking it. Spinning, twirling, dancing. Love life. Yeah! He's a bartender. All right.
I'm just now really realizing I don't have a strainer.
Oh, I have a feeling you can work around not having a strainer.
Let's work with it.
Work with it. All right, it's coming out. Oh, look at that beautiful shade. It's kind of a pink. Somebody might get a cube, and that's okay. Yeah. I thought you'd do that sooner. I love it. All right, it's coming out. Beautiful pink. Yeah, that's great. It's almost like a light crayon. Let's try it. Cheers. It's good. Sweet. But like it's got a little bit of an edge.
You can use tequila on this, of course. I like a little smokiness, so mezcal's my choice.
All right, so who would like a drink? Come on, it's okay. Who would like to try this drink? Well, tough, you can't have it, but what you can have, if you look on your table, you see a bag, and this bag says, don't touch. Now's the time to touch the bag. Touch the bag. Open the bag. Look inside. What you see is a can of a classic Detroit staple, Werner's Ginger Ale, and a little bit of that touch of the Irish, the whiskey. Now, what I want you to do, and I want you to do it quick, take some of the whiskey and some of the ginger ale and mix it in the glass that came with. And if you don't want the whiskey, you don't have to drink the whiskey. You can just use the ginger. But I want you to hurry, because we're about to do something delightful. If when we're all ready, we don't have our drink of the night, that's fine. Just use whatever drink you have. We're just trying to keep the magic going. And that magic is already looking like it's taking effect over there in the hookup. That's great. Okay. If you have the Werner's in whiskey, hold it up ready. If you don't, hold something else up. Ladies and gentlemen, to love, to loving culture, let's get wedded! What is this?
I don't have this in my cards.
Wait, what is that?
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side?
Is that Emmett Montgomery?
Rainbows are visions. Only illusions. Rainbows have not
been told, and some choose to believe it. I know the wrong way to see.
But someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me.
Who said that every wish would be heard and answered? Wished on the morning star. Somebody thought of that. Someone believed him. Look what it's done so far.
What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? What do you think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers,
the dreamers, and us.
All of us under its spell, we know that it's probably magic.
Yeah! Have you been half asleep? And have you heard voices? I hear them calling my name.
Are these the sweet songs that called the young sailors? I think that they're one and the same. And I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers,
the dreamers,
and us.
Everyone!
That is my favorite sad song about hope. Or my favorite hopeful song about death. It works because you feel all of the feelings at the same time when you hear that song. And feelings are good one at a time. But when they're all happening to you at the same time, it can take you someplace. Maybe a place you're not ready to go to, but you're there anyway. There was a August 2nd, 13 years ago, where I woke up feeling all the feelings. I was recovering from 2 days before. I had had my bachelor party at the Rebar, and from what I understand, it was a good time. Many of you were there. I'd love you to tell me about it sometime. But I woke up, and it was my last morning wifeless. If everything worked out, I would be wifed up by the time the sun went away. And I was so happy about it and so terrified about it and felt a sadness I didn't understand and a joy that I hadn't really met yet. And I just felt everything. I didn't know what to do. And the Mormon in me was like, you need to break a rule. So I went to the coffee shop by my house, Fair Art Gallery and Cafe, where I would go when I had lost my keys and I needed an adult, the woman I was dating, to come rescue me. So it was a safe place. I went in there and my friend Alicia Bo was behind the bar and she was like, I'm glad I could see you because I won't be able to see you today because I have to work here. And she's like, how are you? And I said, yes. Yes, I am. I didn't understand. I'm like, why am I afraid right now? And maybe it's because that kind of lonely fear would be going away at the evening. That sort of loneliness is something you wouldn't feel for a while when you find the right person to hold hands with. Maybe it was its last gasp. Maybe it was worried about everything. But I'm like, I should be, how can I be afraid and happy? I don't know to function. And she goes, well, maybe, I'll tell you what, why don't you sing me a song? And so I sang the song that has all of the feelings in it. We sat there, holding hands, singing the rainbow connection to each other, and a guy who was wearing just a vest and very short shorts and reflective shades came in, joined in for the third verse. And when it ended, that silence, he just left. He didn't even... Maybe he'd been hired by the universe to give the moment a little zhuzh, you know? And it helped. It got me to where I needed to go. I found myself in the back room of Chop Suey getting ready for this big moment. And there were some worries that were found. The suit I had required cufflinks. I did not have any cufflinks as a alcoholic in his 20s. But fortunately, my sensible friend, you may know him, Matthew Brennan IV, lent me his green cufflinks, and he didn't need them because I had requested that he wore his Elvis suit and his disco helmet. And we did my friend, who couldn't make it tonight, Chaz Roberts, actually officiated our wedding, and this way, he's okay. And we said the words, and we signed the paperwork, and our wedding was what I like to call a stone soup wedding, where you invited all your friends, and they contribute what they can, and it comes together something more delicious than you could have thought about. Our friend, who was the DJ, she said, I will DJ your wedding, but I get to choose your first song. And now, there I was, all wifed up, looking at a freshly husbanded Kate, and we heard banjo music fill the room. And we danced to the rainbow connection. And on the second verse, my wife, and that was the first thing she really did as my wife, she whispers in my ear, I forgot how long this song is. If you think about that song, that is a song about asking if there's magic, saying one day it will show up, and then eventually realizing that we've heard it too many times to ignore it, that there is a connection with all of us. There is a song, just waiting to be sung. And when you need it, people will sing at you. And that's when I felt connected, not just to the person I had agreed with to hold hands with during the night, but to everyone there and everyone who got me there. And there was more evidence of this magic when Matthew Brennan, who had given me the green, the frog green cufflinks that were around my wrists, stripped to his waist, and proceeded to win a dance battle with American darling Solomon Giorgio. I know that someday we'll find it, but I think today is that someday.
Lover, dreamer, storyteller, and probably the only performer in Seattle named Emmett Montgomery. So, two things. How's it going there? It's good. Good, you talking, you sharing, you drinking. So two things that I would like to share. First off, the bar is open. While people find venues like this to be a sort of church, this ain't church. Feel free, if you're thirsty, if you're parched, if you need to stretch your legs, feel free at any point to go ahead and go to the bar and get a drink. But make sure to tip your bartender. The second thing, at your table, you'll also notice that there are tickets. So I want all of you to grab a ticket because we are going to win a prize. And if we're going to win a prize, there's only one person that can help us win this prize. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. You can do better than that. Ladies and gentlemen, there's only one person that can help us win a prize! Prize! Girl! Brandi!
She still can't hear him say. She hears him say, Brandi.
Damn, it's been a while. All right. Prize girl Brandi, do we have all of the tickets accounted for?
They're all in there.
All right. Let's shake it up. Do you all have your tickets ready? Have your tickets ready. You got yours. You know what? That's something else you got in common. You got those tickets ready. Can we quick neon sign? Where was this level of production value 15 years ago? Maybe we'd still be going. All right, only PBRs. All right, this ticket is 00032019 4. 194-320-194. Come on up! Come on up! Let's see the ticket.
320-194. First off, thank you for dressing up. You look amazing. Works. Friend, what is your name?
My name is Alex.
Alex, where are you from? Alex.
Seattle, Washington.
Alex from Seattle, Washington. Alex from Seattle, Washington. What are you drinking?
PBR.
PBR, the people's beer of the republic. It's been a while since I said that one. All right, let's see what you've won, Alex. First off, we win.
Haunted Detroit.
Haunted Detroit. Detroit and ghosts go hand in hand.
Elvira.
Ooh, a sweet, wait, it's not just Elvira, it's an Elvira pillow. You see, never mind, let's move on, all right.
Some bookends for you.
Ooh, and you know what? You know what you can put right in the middle of those horses? You can put your haunted Detroit book. You also win.
Stickers from Detroit, stickers from New Orleans, keychain of Diana Ross, this cool lighter, Miller Lite can. Buddy's Pizza Cozy.
Buddy's Pizza, local to Detroit. And a Get Loweded bag. Perfect. Because people really win at Get Wedded. So in another world, we would have made a rule, but we're not making a rule, but we are going to raise our drinks and toast Alex, because Alex, you are a winner! So, we are running a little early. I just wanted to make sure, have we given out more bracelets? Have we given out more friendship bracelets? How are we doing on the bracelets? We doing good? We making friends? You got 10 seconds. Let's find something else. Give out another bracelet. Again, bars open, bracelets are being handed out. Fantastic. Okay. All right, coming back in 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're ready to defy gravity. I hope you're ready to go to the stars. As our next guest performed in venues all across the country, including Seattle Symphony Music Hall, the Moore Theater, the Lakewood Theater, the Highball Theater, the Rose Garden, the Crystal Ballroom, the Telluride Theater, and really, again, up among the clouds where only the sun and moon reside, put your hands together and prepare to be dazzled by Michelle Francis!
Just close my eyes again. Climbed aboard the Dreamweaver train. Driver, take away my worries of today and leave tomorrow behind. Ooh, I believe you can.
Doesn't know who she is. She flies. She soars among the clouds. But you know what we do? We win prizes. Who wants to win another prize? Who wants to win another prize? Well, in order to do that, we need prize girl Brandi!
When the bars close down, Brandi walks through a silent town. And love's online, he's not around. She still can hear him say, she hears him say, Brandi, you're a fine girl.
Hookup, are you inspired yet? All right. Get it. All right. Tickets all accounted for. You think they're all in there? You got your tickets ready? 0-0-0-3-2-0-1-6-2. 162-320-162. Wait, are you up? Are you coming forward? No, no. That's no, no one. Going once. Going twice. All right, you're out of here. Drawing another one. Oh wait, do we have it? Come on up. the ticket. It's a ticket. 3201162. We gotta make sure you won. All right, Fred, what is your name?
Mike.
Where?
Uncle Mike.
Uncle Mike! Well, you can come a little closer, Uncle Mike. Uncle Mike, where are you from?
Crozet, Virginia.
Crozet, Virginia. I love it. All right, Mike, what kind of prizes do you think you're going to win?
You know, I think it's going to be good.
Oh, I think it's going to be good too, my friend. All right, let's find out. You win...
Guide to the Weird, Wonderful, and Obscure.
Guide to the Weird, Wonderful, and Obscure of Detroit! We love those things. Ed.
What do you call this? But it's a judge.
A boxing judge? I love it. All right.
Party visor.
I see at least 19 holes in your future.
Budweiser salt and pepper shaker.
Hey! Don't go Bud Light on that salt.
Detroit sticker.
Detroit sticker!
A little crawfish from New Orleans.
Oh, look at that crawfish from New Orleans. That's a cutie.
We got coasters. We got another coaster from Hitsville. And we got a little novelty pin for you.
Little novelty pin.
Bag.
And a bag. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Uncle Mike. Thank you, Uncle Mike. Brandi, Bratrude. I love it. I love it. Winning. Okay. So. As Kyle moves the table over, let's take some selfies. Let's take some selfies. Who's got a camera ready? Who's got a phone ready? We'll take a selfie together. Let's take a selfie. Here we go. Hey, buddy.
Yeah, I missed you.
I missed you too. Hey! Oh, look at that J.J. Abrams lens flare. Who else wants a selfie? Who else wants a selfie? Here we go. Hey, we're gonna ride the dragon on that one. I love it. Oh, Claire Duty, what we got? Yeah, selfie style. Oh, snapping many. I love it. Anyone else? That's good. All right, ladies and gentlemen, hitting back up to the center stage there. Next up, we have a comedian, a writer, a host and actress, and a key contributor to Screen Junkies and Fandom Entertainment. Currently writing for Honest Trailers and probably seen on the GIFs in your virtual meetings, ladies and gentlemen, you know her, you love her, you need to be bossed around by her. I give you Danielle Radford!
Which is 100% about, are you smarter than a child? But we don't have any children here, because that is not how this works. But what we do have are two teams of very able, adept adults. God, I'm hoping. And also, I would love to have your babies. I don't want to have any of your babies. What we usually do is, I just want to let you all know, we have the aunts. There are two teams of people. There is, and I want to present, even though I don't like people, I don't like aunts, Aunt Arena! And also, Aunt Gianni! Come on up to the stage. think who is really talented and dope and doing like engineering and also doing words. So we are also bringing up Redding and also Jackie Kingsbury. Everyone up to the stage. I wrote a bunch of questions. I lost them in the fall. I think they're all in my not my boobs. Oh, these are gonna be amazing. And so, well, no, we're doing a mixie where it's like when a mix. So, over here, go there. Oh God, you look so hot. Go over here. And then you, not yet, you, hot as shit. Get over here. Get over here. With your hot ass. And now we're about to start asking. This is the trivia segment of the show where we ask, are you smarter than anyone in the audience? We had three segments. The first one is, oh, I think I lost them when I fell over. Oh, oh man, y'all are being all tragic like that wasn't a joke. Fucking weirdos. Like you don't know me. So, the first segment is Detroit and facts. So here's the thing. We're gonna do some Detroit facts, but mostly, you know, there is a bunch of sister cities around the country that are important in a bunch of different areas. And so, I've never been good at this. Why are you acting like this is new? So, sister cities. What is the sister city of Detroit? Keep yelling, you're all wrong. One, two, three, last words. Do you know?
No, I'm not the auntie. Toyota.
Yes! Toyota is the sister fucking city of Detroit since 1965. And they also have participated in like a thing where like they both send their kids back and forth to be cute. Huh? Sorry, Toyota. You're right. I should say that out loud. Damn, oh no, you came to play. You were not, okay, well, you are not fucking around. All right. So, another sister city. What is one of the sister cities of Seattle, Washington?
Kyoto.
I'm sorry, you were having an argument about who got it first, and I want to listen to that.
Oh, I don't care who she is.
Wow, wow, wow. I think it's Kobe, but I'm just going to allow it. Yeah, I'm going to just allow it. What is, this is the last one in this round, the first of three, a sister city of Mumbai?
Mm.
One, two, So Mumbai is a hot fucking slut. And that has like 15 sister cities. Yeah, they like to scissor. Los Angeles, St. Peter's, blah, blah, blah. Mumbai loves to have ethical non-monogamy. More like Mumbai. And now, and I'm not, those feel like trick questions. I got it. I'm okay. The last round is things that you would know if you read any of the stuff that people sent you before you got here. Sorry?
I ended up at Trixie's, so that should tell you something.
Well, these would be things, if you were reading any of the stuff about Matt and Brandi, you would know these.
Well, what's the question?
Look, she's not fucking around, and I like her for it. Well, wait, first, no, you're right, I'm wrong. This is, when did Brandi move to Seattle? It's in the reading materials, yes. Yes.
2007.
Yes. It was 2007. You have to buzz in.
2006.
There it is, Jackie Kingsbury. How did Brandi meet Matt?
This fucking shit show!
The answer is this fucking shit show. That is exactly what it was.
Who was the intergender arm wrestling champion of the world? Fuck you, Matt Brennan.
Matt Brennan, Matt Brennan, Matt Brennan.
Yeah, it was Matt Brennan. Obviously, it was Matt Brennan. Here is the last thing, my last question. What is the name of this show? Take a fucking drink! I don't know who won and who fucking cares. We all win. And mostly the winners are Matt and Brandi.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise! The aunties, Jackie Kingsbury, ready to rumble! Winners!
Brandi already had another costume change.
Hot
is this
damn.
Number three? Is this number two?
All right, so we are going to clear the stage. But ladies and gentlemen, I feel like we need to give away some more prizes. Who wants to win another prize? Who's ready to win a prize over here? Are you ready to win a prize over here? I feel like they're more ready to win a prize. Prize go, Brandi!
She still can hear him say, she hears him say, Brandi.
I got the first dance. Hot dog. I love stealing the first dance. I don't know if you know that about Jackson Lowe. Jackson Lowe loves stealing the first dance.
All right, so let's draw a number. All the tickets are present and accounted for. Ladies and gentlemen, do you have your tickets at the ready? The prizes that we've given away so far must be worth at least $5 million.
At least.
At least. All those Detroit books, the prizes that came from New Orleans, the Elvira pillows. Elvira. 0000320192. Woo! We got a winner. Come on over here. Yeah! Look at this strut. I like the way you move, friend. What's your name?
Jack Radden.
Jack Radden. All right. Let's see your ticket. 1-9-2-3-9. They're always checking you. Always checking you. So, Jack, he said. Jack. Where are you from, Jack?
Seattle.
Seattle, Washington. Emerald City, the Rain City, home of grunge, home of not the home of coffee, but Jack from Seattle, you have won. Let's see.
We're going to start with the book, Detroit Tiki. Yes. Okay, this we found in Detroit. It's a nice little box of treasures. So, you know, things for you to look at later. There might be boobs in there.
Wait, I have a feeling. Who here likes boobs? We have those two things in common!
Do you know who this guy is?
Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Randy Macho Man Savage Pillow.
Oh, Jack, you got a vintage Get Loweded tie.
But not just any tie. It's a tie, a Get Loweded tie, sponsored by the People's Beer of the Republic. I haven't seen one of those in at least 15 years.
Yes. We got Stevie Wonder.
Stevie Wonder!
We got Detroit stickers. We got a Werner coaster. We got mustaches and eyebrows.
That'll get you through security, my friend. Let's make some noise! Let's make some noise! Prize go, Brandi! You know, when it comes to Get Loweded, Jackson Lowe can name many parts of the night that are probably my favorite part. Not the least of which is when people might hook up, form a connection, but there's one part where I feel like if I look too long, I might fall in. If I stare too deep, I might get overwhelmed. It's kind of like flirtation, right? Flirtation's alchemical. It's people finding themselves in a moment existing entirely of possibility. And that possibility is a spark that can either ignite a burning flame that can overwhelm us all, or can burn out, fade away, fizzle. Let's hope that this is your chance to be consumed by the flames. But don't look too hard, because ladies and gentlemen, this is the erotic temptress, Evelyn Sinclair! Yes! No! Maybe so! Sinclair. I also want to introduce the backing band for the Motown All-Stars. We are gonna see and hear and dance to a whole lot more of them tonight. That was just a tease. Make some noise for them, please. Whew. Whew. Is it just me, or did it get a little warm in here? Does it feel a little warm to you, Star? It's so hot. Molly, does it feel a little warm to you?
Hot and moist.
Hot and moist! Man, people fucking hate the word moist. I don't get it. I mean... Oh, they're getting along. This is nice. They're smiling. They're staring into each other's eyes, leaning in. Hands being held, heart-shaped bangles, telling the tale. So look, I want you all to look deep in each other's eyes and think about the question that I'm about to ask. Before we answer that question, and I ask that question, I would like to bring out one more time, prize girl Brandi!
When the bars close down, Brandi walks through a silent town and loves a man who's not around. She still can hear him say, she hears him say, Brandi, you're a fine girl.
Okay, so you've been spending time together, you've been getting to know each other, friendship bracelets have been exchanged, but now is the moment to learn. Oh, she strapped her.
I strapped up.
You got strapped up! It feels like a positive sign. Star, tell me what you think of Molly.
Molly's lovely.
Molly is lovely.
Beautiful and funny.
Beautiful and funny. And I'm guessing smart and strong as well.
She probably could kill me.
Ooh, not unsexy. Molly, tell me what you think about Star.
Star's really hot, super smart. I'd do her in an instant.
Oh, so does that mean with prizes on the line, you and Star are gonna smooch? Will there be a smooch? Maybe step in front. Let's see if it's gonna happen. Is there gonna be a smooch? Are you smooching? We have a hookup! I seriously would have been fucking disappointed after 15 years we didn't. At a wedding, for goodness sakes. So, prizes will be won. And you know what? We're not going to go through them. We're just going to share them. You two get to go through them together. Open the bag up yourselves. See what you find inside. But prize girl Brandi, I feel like you and I should make the way to the stage and give away one more prize. So I hope you all got those tickets ready. Get those tickets ready. We're going back to the stage. We're going to give away another prize. Those shoes. Prize girl Brandi, those shoes. Look at those things. Those are beautiful. What are those? Velvet? Okay, I'm going to stall for just 1 minute. Ladies and gentlemen, are you having a good time tonight? We've been giving away prizes. We've been laughing. We've been learning more about the world around us. Who knew Mumbai getting dirty? We almost fell in those alchemical waters of flirtation, also very explosive. And we've been getting loaded, and we've been doing it together. We've been sharing wristbands. And we're going to give away one more prize. Final prize of the night. Do you all have your tickets ready? Yeah. Let's dig down deep in this, because I see some people running around. Oh, no, I think I will pick a good one.
Can you believe the hookup?
They hooked up. They smooched. They smooched hard. I have a feeling there might be some more smooching later.
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed, because that's what happens at Get Loweded. People really win, especially in Detroit, Michigan.
We do have one hookup that turned into a marriage. From way back in the day.
Oh, and I see one member of that union right there in the crowd. All right, let's give away a prize. Let's give away a prize. Tickets to the ready. Tickets to the ready. All right. 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 1.
Thank you.
Cameras out. Take some pictures, people. Take some pictures. We're not doing the kiss yet. We're not there yet. Make some noise! Come on! Now sit the fuck down! All night we've been talking about, we've been talking about coming together, we've been talking about, like, motion, right? We've been talking about how all motion must be initiated. A first domino must be pushed. A number must be called to get the players into action. Every story has a beginning. We all start somewhere. In the case of you two, it started on a night like tonight, well over a decade and a half ago. It'd be fun to say that this story burst into being. A big-budget Hollywood epic featuring Keanu Reeves and Sandra Bullock finding love in the midst of chaos, shared trauma that explosively attracts and mixes up the dopamine-fueled attraction into a bright, burning, baked Alaska of romantic engagement, writhing bodies maintaining speed lest they become a blinding, violent expansion of energy that destroys all in its presence. No, this story is a slow burn. They may have met in that dark room filled with drinks, prizes, comedy, burlesque, music, and drinks, but that was just a preface. The chapters presenting themselves in serialized fashion. Set in a bar once a week, a set resembling a Parisian street. Another in the clouds of Venus and the dust of Mars. 1 week at a time. From over romance novels and through rocks glasses, Brandi would see Matt. Matt would see Brandi. And that's something in itself, right? Being seen. So what do we see? What is this show? This show is time itself. This show is presented on the channel that is gravity. Coming together over small steps. A trip to pick up props here, interactions at a party there, sitting a little closer, week by week, until gravity and time create in chapter 5 a cleared counter. Writhing bodies, and goddamn, what a kiss that I myself witnessed. Hallelujah! What a kiss! Let's drink to that kiss! So that kiss, where do we go? Are we dancing? Are we moving? Are we growing? Are we watching the same shows, exploring the same places, sharing the same time, taking care of business? Well, Brandi, you said this. I think I loved him before I realized it was love. I loved saying yes to him, whether it was to go to a show, get another drink, or take a trip together. I knew when we were together that it felt right. Like the possibilities were endless when we were together. I knew his energy was something I wanted to be around way before we started dating. and that may have very well been love. All that said, I'll just go with the first time I saw him in an Elvis jumpsuit. You had no idea, right? But that's when she knew she loved you. Well, fuck, let's drink to that! Whew! And so they swagger on. Like that polyester jumpsuit made for high action kicks. Bell bottoms swinging with each move. Shit, one could say Brandi is the sparkle on Matt's Elvis jumpsuit. That jumpsuit fits. Now, Brandi, you want to know what Matt said about loving you? You do. Brandi and I found each other, and I still can't believe how much I love her and how well we fit together. We both like cheeseburgers, but I don't like pickles. She does and takes them every time. It's a small thing, but it's how so much of our life really just seems to fit. Neither of us wanted a traditional marriage. Well, you didn't fucking get that. And as we talked about it, a lot of the stuff that was usually assigned to the bride and Brandi hated, I was stoked to take over on. She takes whatever groom parts I don't care about and makes them her own. So much of our lives work like that. We match on the important things and pick up on the other's slack on the details where we both end up happier. We're a team that never competes with each other but has the absolute trust of each other. Never compete and have absolute trust. It takes trust to say yes. And it's that saying yes that you are, that we already brought up, that Brandi loves doing, that's bringing us all here, right now, in this time and space, for what Matt describes as a singular moment for us to bring everyone in our lives together for a celebration of what we have been and will continue to be. Let's drink to that. Let's drink to that. So, what will we continue to be? Before we answer that question, let's see if anyone has any objections so far. Oh, there's objections. Okay. Okay. Okay, so we have objections, apparently. There's an Emmett Montgomery, there's an Evelyn Sinclair, there's a Grant Badger, there's a Michelle Francis, there's a Danielle Radford. Dear Lord. Okay, so Danielle Radford, what's your objection?
I don't think there should be objections at a wedding.
Are we all in agreement there? Well, let's move on. Brandi, what will we continue to be?
It's my turn. It's my turn. Okay. All right. All right. King Brennan. There are so many reasons I love you. You are smart, thoughtful, and creative, which we all know by two things. Always on the hustle. Go two things. But that I get to see in everything that you put energy into. You care about your people in a deep way, and you make sure that your people know they're your people. The way you've cared for me has healed parts of me. You're sweet and funny, and I live for the slow moments where a look across the couch leads to laughing so hard that tears are streaming down my face. You dig into new things with an open mind, whether it's music, art, food, people, places, you name it. I can always count on you to be ready to explore something new. I'm obsessed with your magical frontman energy. Obsessed. Let's see, where am I at here? Here we are, yep. I'm obsessed with the energy and your ability to bring people on a journey with your passion and your wildness and your pure joy for the experiences that you're a part of. Thank you for taking care of me, for making me feel safe. I don't always make that easy. You protect me. Yeah, they know. You protect me and you support me, and I know I've always got you in my corner. You're my biggest encourager, whether it's buying a xylophone off of Craigslist or making career moves that shake up our entire lives. You're my biggest encourager, like I said, and you are just, you, let's see, where am I? Yep, no, I got it. Thank you for celebrating big for my victories and always making me feel so special. After 16 years of knowing you, I know a few things for sure. I know I will always love you. I know I will always say yes to doing new things with you. And I know I will always be there in all the ways that I know how. So Matt, I'm so grateful for you. I am so proud of the life that we share. And I am just excited for all the adventures to come.
Matt, do you have anything that you would like to say?
Why, yes, I do. Dear Brandi McCree Bratrude, there has always been this idea of fate and romance being inextricably linked. That idea is so not the story of us, and I'm glad. We didn't have love at first sight. I don't think either of us knew right away this was forever, but I do know that you saw a picture of me on MySpace holding my dog and said, hell no, right off the bat. Chaz did try to set us up on a blind date, if you don't know. But we became friends first, and then one day, one jello shot filled night, we chose each other. We chose to be around each other, we chose to build a life together, and we chose to make each other better people. It's always been an active choice, and I've always chosen you, and so far, you've always chosen me. Over the last 14 years, that choice has put us in a place where our lives have grown together so inseparably that it's been hard for me to write these vows without referring to just us. But this is about you. I look back on these last 15 years of knowing you, and I wouldn't have it any other way. We were very different people when we met, and I feel lucky that the person I am today loves you as much as that young dirtbag Matt with the rough edges loved the wild stallion that was mid-20s prize girl Brandi. I know that being with you has made my life immensely better, and me an immensely better person. I also know that you're the most beautiful person inside and out that I've ever met in my life. I thought a lot about what I was promising on the stage here today, and the answer is this. I choose and promise to be there for you whenever you need me. I choose and promise to not be there when it's not wanted, and to allow you the room to grow on your own. I choose and promise to keep growing to be a better version of myself and to be worthy of your love. I choose and promise to support you and hold you accountable in your growth and your journey. I choose and promise to appreciate your beauty every day it's in my presence. I choose and promise... I choose and promise to continue adventuring all over the globe with you until we're both tired of it. I choose and promise to love the person you are till I take my last breath.
What? Not yet.
You gotta help the kids.
So, do you both commit to these things as long as seems appropriate?
I do.
I fucking do.
Do y'all want to take one last picture before they're actually married? And while they're doing that, so while that's happening, could we get the ring? Do you have 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 the ring? Who did you give the ring to someone? Is that who? Them who? There's like 20 people on stage right now. Do you have the ring? Kelly, do you have the ring? Brown, do you have the ring? There's nothing in there. Well, I didn't think I'd have to do this, but I have a solution. Ring Maiden! Ring Maiden, are you here? Ring Maiden! Hold the box up, Ring Maiden! In this box full of light, this box full of power, this box full of time, space, gravity, love, all compressed, insert your fingers into the box. And your love and time and space has presented to me. Fucking kiss each other and make it real. Two, three, you are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You made me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Feel free to keep singing. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's get some food. Let's get some drinks. Let's share some love. Get the party started.
Hush now, child, and don't cry. Your folks might understand you by and by. Just move on up toward your destination.
She's a fantastic girl. Thanks for taking a chance on a homeschooled kid like me. College wouldn't have been the same without you. I want to give you good advice. Always take care of your nipples. Wear band-aids over them when you jog. Put some lotion on them once in a while. It's very important to have good nipple health. Bless you.
Ah! Matt, I thought we're a dirtbag, but you're a dirtbag, and I love you. And you're like the best kind of dirtbag, because you're like the bestie kind of dirtbag.
Yes, Brandi, always going to be the coolest person I know, and I'm always going to be happy that even though you were way too cool to talk to me, you did it anyway. I love you guys. Way to be married.
Matt and Brandi, lovely wedding. I got to go to more weddings. All I have to say to you, be excellent to each other and party on, dudes.
That was pretty good. All right, all I got to say is when you guys get married for real, I hope I'm there. I love you. And have a happy life together. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers.
Just, like, I fucking love you. You're what I, like, when I'm in my classroom, not to bring, like, teacher shit in here, but when I'm in my classroom and when I strive to, like, create the community, like, it's this, and, like, I thank you for showing me what love is, what love in a chosen family could be. I can't thank you enough, and just, like, I love you guys.
Matt and Brandi, congratulations. Matt, I'm officially handing off my wife for now, until we get old, and then I take her back into my home. But I love both of you very, very much. Thank you for having me be such a special part of your special, magical, wonderful weekend. I love you.
Matt and Brandi, when I first met you, I was too intimidated to actually talk to you, and because I just realized how fucking amazing everything you did was, and you, despite my awkward quietness, decided to like make me a friend, and I have been nothing but grateful to everything that you've done and been inspired by your willingness to take chances and just generally improve yourselves and everyone in your lives. And I cannot express how much I love you too. And thank you so much for having me be a part of your life.
Congrats.
I just want to say, Matt and Brandi, the point of a wedding is to bring together your community, to engage in their power, to make real the bond that you're forging together. And you have done a fantastic job of bringing that community together tonight. I can't imagine it having been a better time, and I wish you both the very best in your future and forever.
Matt and Brandi, I love you, and absolute best wedding ever. I will probably have a multi-day high from how much fun it was and just meeting all these great people and seeing all the people that we had a million good times with, and it was just, you set the bar. This was the best shit ever, and every instant of it kind of blew my mind, and I'm so glad I got to be a part of it. And come to Mexico, let's hang out. I love you guys, and I guess that's the end of my spiel. Thank you.
Awesome.
Thank you. I feel lucky for being invited.
Thank you so much for inviting us to your wedding. I love you guys. First time ever met, July 4th. Biscuits and gravy on East Lake. And then I fell in love with Brandi in the hot white trash hot tub in the back of her truck. And then we progressed. I love you guys. Thank you so much. Matt and Brandi, most excellent freaking wedding. And we met each other before WXPFL pencil fighting, but that's when I really got to know you two as not only an awesome couple, the fun couple. And we're all Elks members at 92 in Fremont. And what you brought in your energy and just being awesome around there. And you moved to Providence, Rhode Island, the home of the Houlihans, you know, and all that. So you hop, skip, and jump to see family, but you have your wedding in Detroit, Michigan, and thanks for having the most awesome wedding I ever been at. You guys fucking rule.
Brandi and Matt, we love you so much. I don't have anything but good things to say about you, and I'm so happy for you. Cheers.
Congratulations, Brandi and Matt.
Love you.
When it comes to your relationship, always say yes to dessert.
be willing to sue for a truce, or to call for a truce and peace and arguments, and then try to make the other one laugh.
deep words of wisdom, never stop telling you each other that you love each other. Celebrate all the wonderful times that you have together. Say nice things to each other all the time, because that's literally how things stand.
That's what I meant to say.
Yeah. And I love this guy so much, and literally every day we tell each other how much we love each other, so never ever stop.
Yeah, if you're ever married by Chaz Roberts or Jackson Lowe, that shit's forever, kids. Whether you like it or not.
And congratulations.
I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Michelle. And last year, when the gang came out to scope out the area, I just crashed every get-together. So they had to invite me. And it's great. I love it.
Love
Thank
you.
You. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.
Love you.
Thank you. First thing I have to say is dicks and boobs.
All right.
Obviously. No, but yeah. For real. Fucking love you guys. This is hands down the best wedding.
Yeah.
Everyone's been saying yeah. it. Like, it's going like, to be right. the talk of the sure. century, quite frankly, Cha-ching. With this group. And we're just so stoked we were able to be here. Yeah.
We love you.
We fucking love you guys. Congrats.
Amen. Fuck you. You're the fucking coolest dude I've ever seen in my entire life. Fucking way to go. Yay. I'm the best fucking human. You beat me, you fucking bitch. It's cool. I'll do a fucking deucey ass like dudes like this. Yeah, 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 yeah. You're the best person ever. I love you. Brandy's fucking, gosh darn it, she's fucking looking at you. And I'm gonna also do a backflip right now. Watch this. Ready? Yeah, backflip. Alright. I did a backflip. It was sick. I love you.
Matt and Brandy, it still blows my mind that 14 years in Seattle, I'm at the Providence table. I'm so glad that you guys moved to Providence and that we're friends and that I could be part of the celebration. And thanks for my first kiss in 2 years. Love you guys. I hope it's for as long as the universe lets it go, because you guys are meant to be together and I love you both.
All right, Matt and Brandy, it's Stacia here. I love you in Seattle. I love you in New Orleans and I love you in Detroit. I feel the love, and I hope you take it with you wherever you go.
So 20-some years ago, some dude sat a row and a half of me, ahead of me, in Art History 1. And 20-some years later, I'm at his wedding with the most amazing woman. If I could handpick someone for Matt Brennan, it would be Brandy. This is an amazing couple. I cannot wait to see what the future holds for them. It is amazing already, and it will only go better in the future.
Hey, Matt Brennan, I got something to say to you.
I love you.
Listen, we have a lot of beef together. Didn't start off so well, but I cannot be more grateful for the best bosom buddy I've ever had in my entire life. Keep on being you. Thanks for always having my back. I'll see you in Providence. And for my girl Brandy, you know, I can't even say words. You know what's here.
My name is Zach. I'm here with relationship advice. My one piece of advice would be collect all of the photos of your lives together each year and make a little book and just print them out. Just have a book of your photos. You'll really, really, really wish you had known it. So start today.
There's this thing that you try to do as like a comedian and a performer. You try to build a universe and include people, have this community, and Matt and Brandy just, you kind of do it natural. Like the worlds you build aren't just for a stage. I mean, they happen on stages, but they're kind of this infectious forever thing. And I don't know. I think you two bend reality in a way naturally that people have been, that I've been trying to learn how to do for years. And you're just so cool. And just seeing Brandy seeing you effortlessly shapeshift through all those costume changes, not just tonight, but over the 3 years we did Get Loweded, and the the fact that you were so game to be impregnated by a monster and for show and just all of that. Like, I think you were the backing track on how cool that show was. And Matt, seeing you in virginal white and knowing that you were going to lose your virginity tonight, and I have a lot of hope, because as we know, most men, they're the 50% survival win rate. And when Brandi wrecks you tonight, I hope you survive. But if you don't, I think you died doing what you loved. I love both of you. Both my parents are dead. Please be my new mommy and daddy.